Okay, so welcome to our third session on our online review. So at this session, we'll be talking about Ohm's Law. So we'll be doing some discussion on Ohm's Law and also with the power, electrical power, also with the electrical energy. We'll be solving some problems so that we could apply whatever theory we learn on this discussion. Okay, so we have here Ohm's Law. So Ohm's Law, so it is a law, ito isang batas, but it is a scientific law that states that the current flowing in an electric circuit is directly proportional to the impressed electromotive force applied to the circuit and inversely proportional to the equivalent resistance of a circuit. So ito ay ginawa, ito ay formulate ni George Simon Ohm. So mula sa definition ng Ohm's Law, so we could say, pwede nyo sabihin na ang current sa isang circuit, so current I, is directly proportional to the voltage and inversely proportional to the current. So dito, dito. So this is proportionality. So if you are going to eliminate proportionality and write it in a mathematical formula, so magiging I is equal to V over R, wherein our I, so that is our current, the unit for current is ampere, our V is our voltage, so the unit for voltage is volt, and our R is resistance, and the unit for resistance is ohm. So yan yung Ohm's Law. So if example sa isang problem, given ang voltage at ang resistance, then you can solve for the current. So later on in our discussion, we will also try to discuss the Ohm's Law triangle and the power triangle. Okay, so we will proceed to power. So electric power, so it is the rate of using electrical energy. So the unit for electric power is in watts. So what is equivalent to 1 joule of energy in 1 second? So basically, electrical power is equal to electrical energy over time. So ang unit ng power is joule per second, or mas kilala natin to sa tawag na watt, pag plural or pag madami watts. So yan yung pinaka formula ng electrical power. But if you are going to have the power expressed in a voltage or in a current form, so yung relationship between power and voltage, so electrical power is equal to voltage times the current. So yan yung pinaka formula. If sa isang circuit given yung voltage at yung current, then you can solve for the electrical power, and that power, the electrical power, is watts. Then we have electrical energy. So electrical energy is the capacity to do work. Okay, so the unit for electrical energy is kilowatt hour. So yan yung pinaka-unit ng electrical energy. So the electrical energy, it is sometimes denoted by E, but we could not use E because E will also denote as the voltage. So gamitin din yung W. So W for electrical energy is equal to the power times the time. And the unit for that is kilowatt hour. Okay. So, dapat yung power natin dito is in kilowatt. And in order to have our power in kilowatts, so 1 kilowatt is equal to 1,000 watts. Then, aside from watts, meron din tayong horsepower, wherein 1 horsepower or HP is equivalent to 746 watts. So this is a very important relationship. Okay, importante itong relationship na to sa power and sa watts and horsepower. Okay, so yan yung maging discussion natin for Ohm's law, electrical energy and electrical power. Okay, so we will go now to the solving of problems, and also ibabahagi ko sa inyo yung isang technique kung paano mabilis masolve yung mga Ohm's law problem at yung mga problem na related sa electrical power at electrical energy. Okay? So, i-anim na natin ito. Okay? So, maya na yung example na yan. Unahin muna natin yung tinatawag nila, yung tatawag nating okay, so ito tayo. Ohm's law triangle. Okay. So, Ohm's law triangle is used for us to be easy, para mas madali na gamitin yung formula ng Ohm's law, para hindi na dapat tayo pumunta pa sa algebraic manipulation of the formula, which is I is equal to V over R. For example, if the given is voltage and the resistance automatic, you could use this formula. Now, what if the given is volts? So, using algebra, so voltage is equal to I times R. If given ang given is the di pala, ito not given but required. So, ilalagay natin yung word na missing lang, missing. Okay. So, if dito naman sa baba, so if missing ang resistance, so by algebra, we could say that resistance is equal to V over R. So, yan yung magiging formula natin. Ano? Diba ito? Hindi pala R, but I. Sorry for that. Over I. So, yan yung magiging formula natin. But, in getting this formula, kailangan natin gumamit ng algebra. And, if also, if you are going to memorize this one, so medyo madami-dami yung ano, dapat i-memorize. Okay, so ang pinakamaling paraan is gumamit ng Ohm's law triangle. Okay. So, gumawa tayo ng triangle dito. Okay. So, ang ilagay natin sa ibaba is yung V. Tapos, dito sa baba, I, R. So, hatiin natin yung triangle sa tatlo. Tapos, sa taas yung V, I, R. So, dapat ganito yung arrangement. So, para mas madali, so, kung ano yung nasa itaas, yung kaya pag sinulat ito ng ganan, I is equal to V over R, yung talagang sa fractional form. Kung ano yung numerator ng fraction, yan yung nasa taas na bahagi ng triangle. So, V, I, R. Okay. So, paano ito gagamitin ngayon? Okay. So, we could use this one. I'm gonna erase. Could use this one. For example, if you are going to look, so missing yung missing ang I. So, missing ang I. So, wala yung I. So, kasi sa problem, kailangan mong isolve yung current. So, una, isulat mo dito yung wala. Yan yung I. Tapos, kung ano yung natira, isulat mo. V. So, V. Tapos, may bar. Bar. R. So, yan na yung formula. So, I is equal to V over R. Okay. Kunyari ngayon, ang missing is V na naman. V yung missing. So, ibalik muna natin yung I. So, pag missing yung V, so, pwede natin itong takpan dito. So, isusulat mo ngayon yung missing V, tapos equal. Okay? So, pag tinakpan mo to, ano yung natitira? I at R. Tapos lang dalawa is magkatabi. So, dapat yung dalawa na yan is times. So, I times R. So, pwede rin pag medyo nililito kayo, gurahin nyo to. So, ang natira is I at R. So, pwede rin yan. So, yan yung formula mo ngayon for for your voltage. So pag hinahanap yung voltage. Ngayon naman, kapag missing yung R. So missing yung R. So pwede natin burahin or takpan nyo. So isulat natin kung ano yung missing. R equal, so V bar I. So V over I. So without any using algebra or mathematical manipulation, nakuha natin yung formula na kailangan natin if may isang quantity sa ating formula na wala. Okay? Now, ngayon, punta na naman tayo sa power. Okay, power. Okay. So, ang formula ng power is equals to V times I. Okay. So, if sa isang circuit, given yung V at I, we could solve for our power. Okay. Na ngayon, pag missing yung voltage, so, masasolve natin yan as V is equal to P over I. Pag missing naman yung current, so we can solve that one as current is equals to P over V. So, yan. Gamit niyan is also algebra. But if we are going to draw our power triangle, so ang tawag namin ito is power triangle. Okay? So, dito sa taas yung P, dito yung I, dito yung V. So, if for example, hinahanap natin yung power, so takpan natin to. So, we have P, yan yung missing. So, pag tinakpan natin, so ang matitira is, kamo na baka may, bakit may ano dito? Okay, so takpan natin to. So, matitira is I times V. So that will be I times V. At kasi times yan, pwede nang gamitin V times I. Pareho lang yun. Kasi pag times, pareho lang. Or multiply. Pag 3 times 2, 6. 2 times 3, 6 pa rin. Okay. Next, if yung I naman yung missing, so pag titakpan natin yung I, ang matitira is P over V. So yan yung formula. P over V. If V naman yung missing, so, pag tinakpan natin yung V, so matitira P over I. So, P over I. At yan na yung magiging formula natin using the power triangle. Okay. So, with this knowledge, we will now solve example problems. Okay. So, unahin natin yung unang problem. Ito na. Okay. So, a 20-volt battery is connected in series with an 8-ohm resistor. Determine the current drawn. So, resolve natin yung current na kinuha ng ating battery. Okay? So, solution. So, first, para hindi tayo malito, we will draw the Ohm's law triangle. Okay? So, dito yung V, dito yung I, dito yung R. Okay. So, ang hinahanap natin is the current. Current. So, ito. So, current. So, we are looking for the I. So, pag pinakpa natin yung I, so, yung matitira is V over R. Okay. So, yung is V over R. So, ang V natin from the given is 20 volts. So, our V is 20 volts. Then, our R is 8 ohm. R is 8 ohms. So, yan lang yung isa-substitute natin. So, I is equal to 20 volts over 8 ohms. And kuha tayo ng calculator natin. So, you have 20. Kamo na, kasi naka-binary yung ano natin. Setting 20 divide 8. And that will be equal to 2.5. So yung ating sagot is 2.5 ohms. And that is now the answer. Okay. So madali lang. Basta alam natin yung Ohm's Law Triangle, we don't need to memorize the formula, just the Ohm's Law Triangle. Next. So a nichrome testing coil takes 30 amperes when a voltage of 120 volt is applied. Siguro dito, find the resistance of the coil. Okay, so yan lang. Find the resistance of the coil. Okay, so solution. Again, gawa natin yung Ohm's Law Triangle. Okay. Magpas ng konti yung ano. So this will be VIR. So just a little bit tip, if the given is amperes and voltage, or resistance, voltage, current, voltage, and the required is either of the two. So required, so kailangan lang gamitin is the Ohm's Law Triangle. Now if for instance the required or ang given mayroon ng power, then you must also utilize the power triangle. So kasi nito ang given, walang given na watt, so gamitin lang natin is yung Ohm's Law Triangle. Okay, so ngayon the required is resistance, yan yung wala. Okay, so yung R is equal to V over I. Paano nangyari yan? So takpan natin yung R, ang matitira is V over I. Okay, so let's continue this one. So yung V natin from the given is 120 volts. Tapos yung R natin is 30 amperes. Okay, so we have now 120 volts over 30 amperes, and that is equal to, so 120 divide 30, so that will be equal to 4, I believe. So 4. So our answer is equal to 4. The unit for resistance is ohms. At yan na po mga kaibigan, ay ang ating sagot. Okay? So again, we use the Ohm's Law Triangle. Now, try natin gamitin ang power triangle. Okay, ito na may problem. A 200 watt lamp has a hot resistance of 400 ohm. So, di pala to, volts pala to. Okay, ganyan natin. Kasi the doble yung given. So that is a 200 volt lamp has a hot resistance of 400 ohms. What is the power rating in watts? Okay. So dito, magagamit natin yung Ohm's Law Triangle at yung power triangle. Okay. So solution. So, i-analyze natin yung problem. Kailangan natin is the power rating. So power ang kailangan. So, question mark at yan. So if you are going to solve for power, so we use the power triangle. Okay. So that is P, V, I. So ang required is power. So yung power yung tatakpan natin. Yung power yung wala. So P is equal to, so that is V times I. Okay. So V times I. Now i-analyze natin yung given. So dito tayo sa given. So siguro ito talaga ay given. So yung given natin, meron tayong volts, which is 200 volt, at resistance, which is equal to 400 ohms. So wala tayong current, kasi required natin yung current para makuha yung power. Kasi ang kailangan sa power is voltage at current. Sa given, walang current, only the voltage. So from this given, meron tayong voltage at resistance. So malamang we could solve for the current using the Ohm's Law. So kung gamitin natin yung Ohm's Law Triangle, painting also triangle. So this will be V I R. So tatabunan natin yung I, so, kasi yung I yung missing. So I is equal to V over R. So V over R. So ang ating V is 200 volts. Our R from the given is 400 ohms. So yung ating I, so you can solve for I. So gamitin natin yung calculator natin. So it is equal to 200 divide 400. Now it is equal to 1/2 or 0.5. So our current is 0.5 amperes. So substitute natin dito yung mga na-solve natin yung given. So our power is equal to voltage 200 volts times the current yung na-solve natin 0.5 amperes. So ma-solve na natin yung power ng lamp o yung power rating ng lamp. Okay, so dito tayo sa ating calculator. So 200 times 0.5, we have 100 watts. So we have 100 watts. At yan yung answer natin. Okay, so dito dalawa yung triangle na nagamit natin. But of course, na-solve pa rin natin yung problem na hindi na natin kailangan pang madaming mathematics or mathematics na involved. Okay, next. A small light bulb with a resistance of 1,000 ohms is connected across a 120 volt line. So what is the current through the bulb? Okay, so solution. So ang required lang natin is current at given natin yung ohms or yung resistance at yung voltage. So walang given na watts. So we are only using the ohms law triangle. Susulat natin yung ohms law triangle dito agad. So this I, V, R. So we are required to use to solve for the current. So pag tabo natin yung current, ang matitira is V over R. Okay, so yung V natin is 120 volts at yung R natin is 1,000 ohms from the given. So substitute na natin para mas madali. 120 over 1,000 ohms, and using our calculator, 120 divide 1,000 equals, so that will be 0.12. So our current is 0.12 amperes. Okay, so madali lang, using again the Ohm's law triangle. Now we go to the next one. So a 200 lamp has a hot resistance of 400 ohms. So maybe tapos na kaya natin to. Balikan natin. Okay, so I believe na solve natin ito. So, nadoble lang pag ano. Alright, so same na formula lang yan. Same na procedure. And the answer of that will be 100 watts. Okay? So, let's go see to another example. So, the field winding of a shunt motor has a resistance of 110 ohms and the voltage applied is 220 volt. So, what is the amount of power expended in the field excitation? So if we are going to treat this one as a problem involving motors, so kailangan gumawa tayo ng sariling ng diagram. But if you are going to read very well the problem, so the problem states the field winding of a shunt motor has a resistance of 110 ohms and the voltage applied is 220. So, ang ibig sabihin nun is yung voltage na applied is 220 volts. Then, yung field winding is always in parallel with the terminal of our motor. So, ang mangyayari dun, kasi parallel, later on the next few videos, on the next few session, we'll be talking about parallel circuit. Sa parallel, kung ano yung terminal voltage mo, yun yung voltage ng parallel na load mo or parallel na resistor. So dito, yung voltage na nasa 110 ohms na resistance ay equal sa terminal voltage. So, ang mayayari dito ngayon is we are only trying to find, okay, natin solution, the power in our field excitation. Na given sa atin is the resistance of the field winding, which is equal to 110 ohms, at yung voltage sa field winding, kasi nakaparallel na yan, 220 volts. Okay. So, kasi power yung kailangan, we will be using the power triangle. So, dito yung P, dito yung V, I. Kasi kailangan natin yung power, so we will tapakpan natin to. So, yung formula natin is that P is equal to V times I. Okay, so again, looking back sa our given, so given natin meron tayong voltage pero wala tayong current kasi resistance niyang isa. So we could use the Ohm's law triangle in solving for the current. So this will be our V, ano pala, yan V. This will be I, R, sa taas pala yung V. Okay. So, solving for I, so I is equal to V over R. V over R, so I is equal to 220 volts over 110 ohms. And our I is equal to, so gamitin natin yung calculator natin. So, 220 divided 110. And this is equal to 2. So, yung current natin is 2 amperes. So, mayroon na tayong current. So, we can now solve for our power. So, P is equal to voltage is 220 volts. And our current is 2 amperes. So, P is equal to 440. So, i-calculate lang natin para mas sure. Okay, so it is equal, okay, so may nagka-problema ng konti ang ating calculator. Okay. So we have 220 times 2 and this is equal to 440. So 440 watts. At yan na po ang ating answer. So there is a shortcut formula for this if you could memorize this that formula, or kung talagang magaling kayo sa anong tawag doon, sa algebra. So for using algebra, the power is equal to V squared over R. Okay. So if you are going to substitute, so you have 220 squared over 110. Okay, so using the calculator, so it will arrive at the same answer. 20 squared divide 110, this is equal to 440. So 440 watts. So ito, nakukuha to by using algebra, or meron tayong tinatawag na Ohm's law rule, kung saan doon nakalagay ng formula lahat from if the required is current, the required is power, the required is ganun. So there are all there are I believe 12 formulas. If you could search that on the internet, pwede you could memorize this that formula. Pero as for me, so mas okay na mas okay na ganito yung dalawang Ohm's law at yung power triangle yung gagamitin mo. Kasi the time needed to solve this one is pareho din sa time na needed mo to memorize all of the 12 formulas. Okay, next we have a bank of lamps operate at 12 amperes and a voltage of 120. What power is taken from the AC mains? So we'll just rephrase this one because ang ano kasi ang kailangan nating isolve is ang power sa AC. So this will be a little bit advanced. But if you are only try to consider the lamp, so yung incandescent lamp lang. So an incandescent lamp is purely resistive load. So we could directly use Ohm's law triangle or Ohm's law kung yun yung magiging load natin. Because ang ating main is AC. So AC kasi meron tayong inductive, capacitive, at resistive load. So later sessions, ma-explain din natin yan. But sa ngayon lang is we are using Ohm's law because we are assuming that our lamp is incandescent lamp. So the lamp is a resistive load. Okay, so if you are going to solve for the power here, solution. Okay, so if you are going to use the Ohm's law triangle, so medyo naslant na ng konti yung Ohm's law triangle. The power triangle natin. Okay, so we are required to solve for the power. So power is equal to V times I. Then yung given natin, yung I natin is 12 amperes, yung V natin is 120 volts. So given na lahat, so we could directly solve. So we have 120 volts times 12 amperes. So that is equal to, so dito tayo sa calculator natin. Okay. So 120 times 12, and this is equal to 1440. So 1440 watts. And this is now our answer. Okay, next. A 5 horsepower motor unplugged at 230 volts. So find the current flowing in the circuit. So ang motor natin is sinusuplayan ng 230 volt line. So kailangan lang nating isolve ang current. Okay. Solution. Okay, so 5 horsepower. So the required is current given yung horsepower. So malamang gagamitin natin is the power triangle. Given yung power at yung voltage, so the required is current. So pag tinakpan natin yung current dito, yung I, so matitira is P over V. So yung V natin is 230 volts at yung I natin, P natin is 5 horsepower. But our power to be able to use this formula, para magamit natin itong formula nito, must be in what? So i-convert natin to. So ang ilalagay natin yung 1 horsepower sa ibaba so that we could cancel our horsepower. 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watts. Okay, so ang matitira sa atin na unit ngayon is now watts. So 5, nangyari dyan, 5 times 746 over 1. Or kapag ginawa natin yun, any number divided by 1 is equal to the number. Okay, so nangyari dyan is 5 times 746. So kapag dinivide natin yung 1, so parang wala, parang hindi rin tayo nag-divide. So kaya atin lang i-redirect ito. So we have 3,730. Okay, 3,730 watts. So kompleto na yung given natin. Ito yung substitute. We have 3,730 watts over 230 volts. So, gamitin natin yung calculator natin. 3,730 watts divide 230. Okay. So, our answer now is equal to 16.2. So, i-ano natin to, round up. So, 16.22 amperes. At yan na yung answer natin. Okay, next. So, So we have the hot resistance of a 100. What is the hot resistance of a 100 watt 220 volt incandescent lamp? So now we are looking for the resistance given yung power at given din yung voltage. So kasi given yung power at voltage, we'll be using also the power triangle. But first, we are going to tackle the Ohm's law triangle muna. In order for us to know what is the formula required for us to solve for the resistance. This is V, this is I, this is times R. So our R, tatakpan natin yung R natin, matitira is V over I. Okay, so ating given, so V is equal to 220 volts, P is equivalent to 100 watt. So walang given na I, but using the ohms the power triangle, kasi sa power triangle may I, so P V I. So dito natin masasolve yung I. So our I, itatakpan natin to, is equal to P over V. So meron tayong power na given, which is 220 volts, ano, not 220 but 100 pala, 100 watts. Tapos yung V natin is 220 volts. Okay. So our I is equal now to, so calculator natin to. Okay, so medyo ano. Okay, so we have 100 divide 220 at equals to sa 0.45. Okay, we have 0.45 amperes. So meron natin current, yung voltage is already given, so we can now solve for our resistance. So R is equal to V over I. So I is V is equal to 220 volts. Our I is 0.45 amperes. So R is equal to, so medyo nagsarado yung calculo natin. Okay, so nag-start na. So we have 220 over 0.45. Okay, and that is equal to 488.8. So 488.8 ohms. At yan na yung answer natin. Okay, so for our final problem, ito na pala yung decision. So yun na yung magiging final problem natin. But of course, we will be also tackling about ito. So gagawa tayo ng isang problem. Para naman may example tayo with in terms of using the power, using the formula for electrical energy. Check mo natin yung spelling natin. This is hot resistance. Okay. So, okay. So, we have find the electrical energy used for a 220 volt toaster used for 3 hours if the hot resistance of the heating element is 100 ohms. Okay. So, solution. So, ang kailangan natin is the electrical energy, which will be in kilowatt hour. So kailangan natin yung power at yung time. So yung time natin dito, yung T must be in hours. Tapos yung P natin must be in watts. Okay. So first yung given natin, the given. So yung voltage is 220 volts, yung resistance is 100 ohms at yung time natin is 3 hours. So okay na tayo sa time kasi dapat naka-hours. So given yung 3 hours, ang wala sa atin ngayon is the power. Okay, so we use the power triangle. This is P, V, I. So solving for P, so P is equals to V times I. Meron tayong voltage, wala tayong current. So we will go to Ohm's law triangle. So V, I, R. So solving for I, I is equals to V over R. So meron tayong V, which is 220 volts. Our R is 100 ohms. So we will have 220 divide 100. So it is equal to 2.2. So we have 2.2 amperes. So we can now solve for our power. So power is equal to 220 volts times 2.2 amperes. So power is equal to 200, sama itong ano natin, 220 times 2.2 and this is equal to 484. So we have 484 watts. Dapat kasi yung required dito must be in watts, but hindi na dapat in watts eh. Dapat to kilo, must be in kilowatts. Okay. Must be in kilowatts. So, ang gagawin natin, yung watts natin is i-convert natin into kilowatts. So, that will be, sa baba natin ilagay yung watts. So, 1,000 watts is equal to 1 kilowatts. Okay, so mangyayari dyan is 484 times 1 over 1,000. So, we have 484 times 1 over 1,000. And this is equal to 4.84. Okay, 4. Di yata 4.84 to ah. Ah, wakaya pala. 100 ang dapat 1,000. So that will be 0.484. So 0.484 kilowatts. So solving now for our work, so W is equal to P times T. So our P is 0.484 kilowatt and our T is 3 hours. Okay, so solving that one, so we have 0.484 times 3 equals 1.452. So we have 1.452 kilowatt hour, and that is our answer. Okay, so for every, sa lahat ng ating diniscuss na problem, meron na tayong mga example. So we have 9 examples na nilibigay for this session. And again, thank you for always supporting this video and also supporting my channel. If hindi pa kayo nakapag-subscribe, kindly subscribe because I'll be releasing this type of online discussion videos every Saturday at 1:30 p.m. Philippine time. So, pwede rin ito ma-view at a later date kasi nasa channel lang ito. The importance of subscribing to this channel is para ma-notify kayo. So once you subscribe, you click the bell and notify all. So that will be also notified sa lahat ng mga videos related to RMA. May mga videos din ako related to mathematics and also sa mga BSE, so mga gustong mag-take ng engineering courses or engineering board exams. So meron din akong mga videos na related doon, and also I'll be planning to have a online session like this one para naman sa electrical engineering na board exam. So again, thank you for always watching, and I hope you subscribe and support this channel para makontinue ko ang mga ganitong video. So as always, like I always said, enjoy learning.